in-laws?
Well, I do have a life outside of you and your brother. I have other clients. But speaking about your brother, he's in jail. He's going to stay there until his arraignment. And I doubt then he's even going to make bail.
Believe it or not, I too have a life outside my brother. I'm not here about Julian. I'm here about me.
Well, why am I not surprised? So, what hole have you dug yourself into now?
It gives me great pleasure to inform you that this time, I'm not in any trouble at all.
Whoa, give me a minute to get over the shock.
I'm not looking over my shoulder. I'm not waiting for the other shoe to drop. I mean, really, what was all that constant worrying getting me? Nothing.
For heaven's sakes, Ava, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
Well, you know, I'm still pretty new to this optimism thing, but I like it. And I think that it's starting to pay off. My relationship with Kiki, it's improving. Scott, did you see that sunset tonight?
No, I was in court.
It was spectacular. Maybe it's always like that. I wouldn't know. I didn't look, but I'm looking now. Thanks to you and your advice.
Well, look at that. Maybe I should give up representing innocent people. Maybe I should become one of those self-help guys, you know, sort of a guru, you know, and make those videos where you bring out the brilliance in people.
You know, that's actually a pretty noble idea.
Well, that's also where the big money is.
Listen to me, before you go off and you buy some spa at Big Sur and set yourself up to be the next guru for the stars, you should know. I'm sorry to tell you this, but it wasn't an inspirational message that helped me change my attitude.
Well, what was it then?
It was your assurance that Morgan's pills won't come back to bite me. I'm putting that dark, ugly chapter behind me once and for all.
Well, you know what? I am glad that you've taken my advice to heart. You know, as they say, seize the day. So what do you say we go have some martinis and see where that takes us?
Wait, we haven't even talked about why we're here. My case. Now, I know that you like to talk about money up front, so I'll tell you, I'm willing to pay anything.
What case?
It's come to my attention that Sonny and Carly are headed for divorce court. Now, what is catastrophic for Sonny is typically very good news for me.
Why is that?
It was a year ago at the nurse's ball that Carly blackmailed me into giving up Avery.
Yeah?
Well, obviously, Scott, that means that Carly is no longer on Sonny's side. So this could be the perfect opportunity for me to get my little girl back.
I'm saying this not only as your lawyer, but as your friend. You just need to relax and enjoy your newfound tranquility.
Scott, have we become friends?
Of course we're friends. If I was just your lawyer, I'd take your money.
But no, all I want you to do is review and reaffirm the original decision granting me custody.
Yeah, but you have misread all of this because Sonny and Carly will always be loyal to each other. You understand that? Especially when it comes to their kids. I mean, they may seem like they want to kill each other, but when kids are involved, they put up a united front.
I have to do something. This might be my best chance to get Avery back.
Do nothing. It's your best chance to stay alive. If Sonny and Carly found out that you had anything to do with Morgan's death, they would